Well, I went to the co-op and got some lime and been putting it down on all the plants because the soil here is depleted by so much of it, I'm sure. Although everything is coming up fairly good here by the house. There's a Cherokee tomato, and I've got jalapeno peppers and cayenne peppers and bell peppers up here, orange and green. And that's a ghost pepper, a real hot pepper. But look how that's actually tall. It's like 6 inches above the ground. It's been staying right above the ground since I planted it about 3 weeks ago. And the rest of them are peppers over here in that tomato plant. And I replanted a branch of a tomato. I didn't think it would take, but look how green it is. It's been 2 weeks. And I just broke off a branch. They say break off a branch and stick it in the soil, and it'll grow roots eventually. And there you go. Proof, it does. I believe that's a sunflower. I'm not positive on that.
Boo.
Yeah, but we'll put lime out here on this. I put it out once before. I did it a second time, and that's all I'm going to do until 2 weeks, perhaps. But the tomato's been growing. We've had brown spot all over these. I've been pulling the branches off of them, the leaves, and going back as far as the branch, all the way like this one here, for an example. You see this? So it goes back so far, and I'll break it off here, leave the healthy under. Leave the healthy under from that point back. It's healthy. It should heal. But and look at how good they've been coming out now. Okay, these are two of them up to my shoulders. This one's almost up to my shoulders. The size of the tomato. See my hand next to it. That's about bigger than a baseball. Almost a softball size, actually. That one too, you can see inside there. I can't see on this viewfinder. But there's about six different type varieties of tomatoes out here. All heirloom. We got hot peppers. We got bell peppers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. About 18 or 20 peppers out here in this first row. All the way back, and there's a grass spot, and then it went over in the back. And we got two rows of tomatoes, not complete rows, but just different varieties. And I started putting down lime, and my wife is watering in the ground. But you see the tomatoes. I mean, this is August 2nd, and that's the closest to red right there. That one there is turning. We've picked some green ones, though. We have picked some green. I had a green for the 4th of July. I think it was on the 5th, actually. I had a green, fried green tomato, two of them. But, see, just show you with that brown spot. I've been picking so many leaves off. I picked this one almost bare. I didn't mean to kill it, but the tomatoes on here stayed green. Look at the branches, how they're all killed off. But see the leaves on here? That's new leaves. That's new leaves since I started putting down the lime. So leaves will start coming out on the branches. I don't know if I'll get more tomatoes on here. There are two on here now. So we'll see what happens. And my little one, I just do it for the sake of doing it to the little ones. There's about three of them like that. See? I put some lime down there and see if I can get tomatoes off. And if they do, they'd be like my little miracle tomatoes. Okra. Green stem. Well, again, I can't see in the viewfinder, so I'm hoping I'm getting in the right areas. There's a green stem. Red stem. I can see the red stems on the viewfinder. There and there. There. And then there's another green one, then a red one in front, and then a green one. So I got three green and four red stem okra tomatoes. I mean okra tomatoes. Okra. Heirloom okra. We've picked off about three or four of these. Four of these big ones. We sliced them up. So, I mean, they get long. 7 inches long, which is kind of... That's getting too long, but you can get it at that point. See, like right here. This is about three, almost 4 inches right here. I'm going to get rid of it. I might take that one off later today. And then there's one right there. If I can see on the viewfinder right there. It's about 3 inches. Two watermelons. We've got four watermelons. Huh? What is that?
Bathroom cleaner.
Bathroom cleaner to get rid of wasps. Okay, see that watermelon right there? That's a good size one. Well, not a good size one, but compared to not having them, we got two that size. The only two coming out of here right now, but look at how healthy the watermelon plant is still. Let me zoom out. All the grass through it. See all this crap right here is no good, but I'm gonna see the watermelon here. It's about 14 inches long, probably about 5 pounds, almost 10 pounds maybe. Black-eyed peas, I got 8 of these right here in cages. Look how tall that one is, the first two. Purple pole beans. I got 2 rows of that. I'm gonna make it all that back row there. That's gonna go all the way back, with this row won't be here, to be over there. That'll be the end of the garden next year. And I put tomatoes up here, 7 tomato plants and 5 pepper plants. And I think that's a pepper plant in that pot right there. I haven't transplanted that. And my wife is spraying wasps with bathroom sprayer. Is it killing them? Yeah, well, I gotta take them out and put gas. I'm gonna burn them. Burn a little spatch in the grass or something.
This stuff would foam up and then they can't fly.
Fly, right. Foam up on them. Make sure they foam up. Oh, yeah. Sometimes foam is a good thing. There's the zucchini back there. Got 2 on that one big plant. Been showing 1. Now there's 2 back there on the big one. Oh, well. Might as well walk back there. I don't want to make the video too long. It's under 10 minutes. It's good. I haven't been able to record my transfer my videos lately. That's why I haven't put any on, but just erasing them. But I gotta get these on here because it's first week of August. Grandpa Paul's gonna be on C-SPAN later on, so at 11 o'clock our time. See, there's one right here. And where's the other one I saw? Right there, you can really see it on that flower. Now, the first year in 2010 we had these, they spread out like that watermelon plant did over there. And we had them, honestly, I am not exaggerating, about 14, 15 inches long. No one could believe they were zucchinis because I said they were heirloom. But my mom's soil must have been a whole lot richer than this is. This was a chicken coop out here about 35, 40 years ago, though. That's the reason I was told, well, why don't you try out here? You should still be pretty fertile, but 35, 40 years ago. And with the spraying up in the sky, the soil gets depleted, and we've been trying to grow. See, look at the peas. Some people out here I've helped with my heirloom seeds, gave them away as a gift. They've had peas crawling across the ground. They said they've had pea after pea after pea already. See, and I put these in cages. Didn't know I should just let them go across the ground. And after that, I learned. I took the cage off this one. This one here's got 1 pod on it, right here. On pea pod. Those are green arrow peas or sweet peas, whatever you want to call them. See, I have to pull this grass out all the time by hand. Just come over here and paw this little bit out. Like I said, but next, well, this fall, after this is all picked, from this row forward, this will be all purple pole beans. And I'm gonna take those purple pole beans right down there or go up to the sunflowers and put them behind here, and they'll go all the way back. That'll be the end of this garden. Back there where those zucchini are will be zucchini. We'll have cantaloupe and maybe watermelon or vice versa. But then everything back this way will be condensed a little bit better. It'll be nice and neat, and we'll have about 12 rows. And the first 3 rows will be peppers and 2 rows of tomatoes. And the 4th row will be okra, so that'll stay the same. Everything else I'm gonna condense a little bit and make it really organized. We got eggplant back there. Where is it? Yeah, eggplant back there. And it'll be really plentiful if everything goes okay. If we don't go into World War III and then they tell us we can't do this, so that'll be another fight. Tell me I have to get a permit to be on my own private land to do this? I don't think so. I'm just almost aching for that. Okay, there you go. That's the garden. August 3rd, 2014. And then the Monsanto soybean all around us. Monsanto soybean.